Factoring tricks, perfect squares. For this, we're going to start by looking at the expression a plus b, and that whole quantity is squared. Remember, when we square something, that's the same thing as taking that expression and multiplying it by itself. So that'd be a plus b times a plus b. Then we can FOIL, and our first terms will give us a squared, and then our outside terms will give us ab, inside terms ab. So add those two together and we'll have 2ab. Then our last terms, b times b, will give us b squared. So one thing that we might notice about this right here is that we have something squared at the beginning and something squared at the end. So our trick right here, our factoring trick, is that if we can take the square root of the first term and the last term, it may be a perfect square trinomial. And a perfect square trinomial means that you can make it one single thing with a squared next to it, something times itself. But this may right here, we are going to have to check and make sure that we're actually getting this 2ab in the middle. Because it is possible to have something squared at the beginning and the end and not be getting this. So we'll check that as we work through our examples. Okay, so our first example here, we've got x squared minus 10x plus 25. So we can notice right here that we've got an x squared at the beginning and a 25 at the end. Both of these are perfect square numbers. So we could say that, you know, could possibly be an x plus 5 squared. Because then we'd have the 5 squared would give us 25 and the x squared would give us x squared. But we want to check and see whether or not it's following this pattern, so we want to see whether or not we're going to get this 2ab in the middle. So we would take 2 times a as our first term, times b as our second term, and we would get 10x. So it looks like this is pretty similar to what we had in the middle here, except that there's a negative sign in the original problem. So it looks like we need something a little bit different. So let's go ahead and try this with x minus 5 times x minus 5, which is the same thing as x minus 5 squared. So let's FOIL this out and see whether or not we get our original expression. So the first terms together will give us x squared. The outside terms is minus 5x. Inside terms, minus 5x. And the last terms, plus 25. So when we combine like terms, we'll get x squared minus 10x plus 25. And we got our negative 10x, exactly what we wanted. And this term now matches our original expression. So we can now say that this right here is successfully factored for the expression. And we're going to want to write this as x minus 5 squared, because it'll be simpler and shorter. So remember that when you get two things that exactly match, you can rewrite them as just a single term squared. So let's go ahead and check out example 2. So example 2, we've got 9x squared and 25y squared for our first term and our last term. So this 9x squared, I'm seeing that 9 right here is a perfect square. It's 3 times 3. So this could be 3x right here. And then our last term, right here, we've got 25y squared. So 25 is a perfect square. That's 5 times 5. And then the y. So this might be what we're looking for right here. And again, we want to check and make sure that we're getting this 2ab for our middle terms. So 2 times a is 3x times b is 5y, and that is giving us 30xy. Haha! It exactly matches our middle term up here. So it looks to me like this should be, oops, forgot my squared. Squared. This right here should be our successfully factored expression. But we are going to double check this. We want to go ahead and actually FOIL out 3x plus 5y times 3x plus 5y. Okay, multiply the first terms together, 9x squared. Then the outside terms together, plus 15xy. Inside terms together, plus 15xy. And then our last terms together, plus 25y squared. Combine like terms gives us 9x squared plus 30. XY plus 25y squared. And that exactly matches what we started with. So this is indeed our successfully factored final answer. So whenever you are given a factoring problem and you notice that it has a square number for the first term and a square number for the last term, you want to try using this trick, seeing if it is a perfect square.